I was a Windows user since late 90s, when I was a kid. Microsoft worked hard this year to make Linux much more appealing than Windows. So yeah, I use Arch, by the way. For a while now, using Windows felt like being a victim in an abusive relationship. You feel like you don't have a choice, and still you continue to endure. You hope for the best, and nothing better ever happens. So yeah, I decided to switch to Linux Mint at first, thanks to PewDiePie's video, and then I tried Arch. Why Arch? Because I decided to challenge myself. And you know what? The funny thing is that it wasn't even half as hard as I thought it would be. It wasn't even remotely scary. I simply downloaded the ISO file, burned it onto the flash drive, booted the flash drive, and installed using the Arch install command. And no, I'm not going to claim my superiority over Windows users. There are many really good reasons to stay on Windows. But I'm tired of feeling like a doormat for Microsoft. And no, I'm not going to tolerate this anymore. I decided that I'm going to switch to Linux because I don't want Windows to handhold me and to obviously try to force me to install their stupid ass Windows 11. I'm not going to tolerate the AI, I'm not going to tolerate the bloatware anymore, I'm not going to tolerate the recall function, and I'm not going to switch to that dumbass interface. Go fuck yourself, Microsoft. Oh, hey, hello. Are you sure that you don't want to use Microsoft Edge as a default browser? Maybe you want to give it a try? Hey, look, by the way, we updated the File Explorer. Now it's not your computer, it's actually this computer. Wink, wink, smirk, smirk. You don't want to get updates. We get it, we get it. Okay, so for how long do you want to not get updates? 1 week, 2 weeks, 4 weeks? Hey, look at this new feature we added to your start menu. Now you can enjoy the Minecraft ads, Roblox ads, and Candy Crush ads at the same time, just from your start menu. Oh, by the way, we had to update your calculator because we have to track your activities in calculator. Oh, and by the way, don't be bothered. We are just updating your Windows 7 PC forcefully to Windows 10. Don't bother, don't you bother, don't worry. By the way, we noticed that you used a debloater to remove all the bloatware from your PC. So yeah, next time you're going to reset your computer to update, we're gladly providing all this bloatware back to you. Oh, by the way, we noticed that you use an external audio interface, so we randomly switched your audio output to a back panel audio jack by default for your comfort. Why don't you use a Microsoft account? Okay, true, you can create a local account. Just press this little hyperlink at the bottom corner of the screen. Oh, I noticed. Damn. Well, are you sure that you do? Okay. We're almost done installing your new Windows 10. Just in case, we wanted to make sure you prefer personalized ads based on your behavior, or maybe you just want random ads. Aha, you're looking for a disk partition manager on your PC. But anyway, here are results that you can find on Bing search engine. I use Arch, by the way. The end of support for Windows 10 was the tipping point for me, and hopefully for many other people. I think before 2022, it was 0.2% of Linux users on home PCs. For the last years, thanks to Valve and Proton compatibility layer, it was 2%. Today it's 3%. Hopefully next year we're going to reach 20%. And yeah, I don't think I have a horse in this race, but still I decided to take a side, as dumb as it sounds. And yeah, 20% is unrealistic, but still. It's pleasant to imagine Microsoft squirm as they lose customers and understand the gravity of their stupid mistakes. So, I guess there is no real point to this video aside from me ranting about Microsoft. Yeah, I installed Arch Linux out of spite. If you're interested about the problems I encountered on my way and how I solve these problems, I think you could stick around. So, I guess I'll see you next time.